It's been 3 years since that game. You know, obviously that moment in the moment was the best moment of anyone's careers. How has that moment stayed with you? How is that, you know, there's not a basic way to ask that question. I'm sure everyone has similar answers, but just to hear from everybody on just what does that moment still mean? How does it still resonate 3 years later?
Oh, I think it shows us that we're family. I think that's like first and foremost, like that's kind of something that we're all going to remember for the rest of our lives. And like 3 years later, we're here watching the game again, talking like we're all in college again on the same team. And I think that's what's going to really resonate with us forever. We'll always be this tight-knit family that went to the Sweet 16.
I think too, though, just like with like just as March Madness was like over, like you were a part of March Madness. Like you went and you were a part of like the Sweet 16 and you like made history. Like that's like, I know a lot of people like I was just with overseas or like never partaked in March Madness and they thought that was the coolest thing ever. And you look back and you're like, wow, you actually were a part of something. So I think that like speaks volume too.
Yeah, I think it's more like looking back at the moment, I don't think we realized how, like obviously we realized how big it was, but now when you look back, you're like, okay, like we did that. And we never questioned ourselves as could we do it. I think that's the thing that resonates with me the most is that like, you went to practice after we won the MAC and it was like, okay, we're going to win another two games. Like it was never, okay, we're done. Like it was, we're going to win two more. So yeah. It's kind of cool.
What this reminds me of is a video that we watched before the game with South Carolina. It was from the QU alumni. And I'm sure like most of our team was crying at that video, but it just goes to show you how big it was. It's bigger than basketball. How many people we like affected, not including like ourselves and our coaching staff. So it was just huge.
Yeah, I think we struggled that season so much. And even in the MAC tournament, all the games we came being behind. And then when we won the title, we knew like this was prepared us for the win. So we just went in and it was like a perfect combination and finale of the of our season. It was so good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it just set the standard for where, you know, Quinnipiac wants to go from here on out, right? I mean, getting to the Sweet 16, like, not, unless we're getting back there and getting further, like, winning the MAC tournament's not enough anymore, right? That should be an expectation. And, you know, just getting to that point again, like, there's no better feeling than that. That locker room after the game when we poured the Gatorade on Coach, I have the picture in the clip on my – just going back and watching that, like, you never forget that feeling. It never leaves you.
Have you ever celebrated anything like you celebrated in that locker room?
No.
No. I remember that like it was yesterday.
I mean, you all said it really well. I'm going to probably start crying if I, if I like really get into this. But no, I think, you know, just the NCAA tournament in general, you grow up playing basketball, you grow up watching it, you watch the upsets, you know, you watch teams win over and over again. And then growing up, it's like, I want to do that. And, you know, we did it. We won two games. We ended up losing to the eventual, you know, champs of that year. So obviously nothing to be upset about. And I couldn't be more proud to do it with all these girls on the screen, plus a few that aren't here right now. It's definitely a feeling. I think every year I get it now. It's, every year I watch it, I get the, you know, the reminders on Facebook, on Instagram, and every time it just puts a smile on my face, regardless of what I'm doing. And I can be, yeah, more proud of everyone.
Aw, Mark. I think one thing that I remember from that trip is, like Del was saying, that was kind of the goal is to get to the NCAA tournament and win games. But I don't know if you guys remember this, but it was the practice we had before we played Marquette. And, oh my God, I'm probably going to start crying.
See?
I'm going to.
Carly.
Okay.
No, I'm going to cry again.
No, I know. But it was the practice before Marquette, and my crying. No, when Coach brought us in, I know. And then Coach brought us in, and she was like,
when we win tomorrow, you know, don't act surprised. Like, this is what you guys have worked for. And I think we just kind of, like, went in there. And, you know, obviously we don't see each other a lot anymore. Oh, my God, I can't believe I'm crying like this.
I'm about to start crying.
But, no, seriously, and I think we all really, I know, we all really care about the program. And, like, we were part of the best team ever to play at Quinnipiac. But I think we all, you know, we care about the culture. And that's, it's a special group. Like, we want that for the, you know, the Bobcats there now, and we just want to see the program, like, you know, get back to that spot, just because I think, you know, like Morgan was saying, like, that was, and Addie, like, that was the happiest moment of basketball ever in my life, you know, and just seeing all those memories, it's like, I can't believe I keep getting so much older, but really, this was awesome. Thank you so much, Nick, for bringing us all together to watch that. That was a lot of fun.